Welcome to another episode of Light the Wick. I'm your host, Ashley Munson. On today's show, we will explore our local White House Fruit Farm, a Ford Theater production, and we'll feature some interesting events here in Youngstown. All that and more on this episode of Light the Wick. Recently, the student government collected donations for those affected by the hurricane in Puerto Rico. They still need the help of students and the community to raise more funds for the disaster. Our very own Joe Cisliano has the story.
We're with Student Government Association, and we're collecting donations to send down to Puerto Rico. We're partnering with the Brookfield United Methodist Church, and we're going to be sending donations to them so they can send them over to some disaster relief locations down in Puerto Rico.
We're collecting items specifically like baby food and diapers and hygiene products and batteries. Those are the specific items on our list, but obviously in a time of need, we'll take anything.
We've been doing this since Monday, and today's actually our last day that we're collecting donations. We've been doing it for the past 3 days. We're going to be sending them over to the church by the end of this week so they can get them out to Puerto Rico as soon as possible. We actually did something similar for Hurricane Harvey, except with that we mostly took the lead on it and we sent a whole truck full of donations down to Texas. We partnered with the Texas A&M student government and had them distribute it to local charities as well as the...
On October 17th, I visited the McDonough Museum next to Bliss Hall on Wick Avenue. On the first floor was the Kelly Connell exhibition, Double Life, 15 Years. The images on display are two or more negative prints scanned and manipulated to create the stories Connell wants to portray. Each image documents the same woman interacting with herself using different posing, styling, and lighting. The work represents the questioning of sexuality and gender roles that shape the identity of the self and intimate relationships. The gallery will continue through November 3rd. There is no cost to visit the exhibit. Many people may not know, but Youngstown State has a reputable theater which holds many original plays. YSU's very own Ford Theater is showing the production of Spring Awakening. With cast and crew both hard at work, we got to take a look behind the scenes.
I am the director of Spring Awakening, which means that I work with our choreographer, Rachel Palermo, and our music director, Ian Leroy, as well as our team of designers, and our stage management team, and of course the actors, to bring the show to life. Spring Awakening is a modern piece of musical theater. Originally premiered on Broadway 10 years ago, this very year in 2007. Part of my job as director is to visualize what this show can be, to take the script and to break it out into its potential, and then to work with a big team of people to make that happen.
I'm playing Melchior Gabor in Spring Awakening. It's a challenging role, it's a fun role. I'm having a blast, I'm learning a lot. This is my first time in a musical, so it's a lot to take in, you know. All the different aspects of musical theater, the acting, the choreography and dance, and the music, all those aspects coming together and having them meld into one thing, and it's a lot of work.
Another special aspect of this production is that the Theater Honor Society is working to be more inclusive to the community by having a sign language interpreter for one or more performances. Spring Awakening will be in Ford November 10th through the 19th. Friday and Saturday shows start at 7:30 p.m. and Sunday at 2 p.m. Last week, the Dana School of Music welcomed Maria Sismic as a guest lecturer for their musicology presentations. Sismic's lecture was titled Cinematic Trauma, Empathy and the Music of Arvo Pärt. The lecture featured film scores and how they invoke empathy from the audience. Sismic demonstrated this using film clips set to the music by Pärt. Sismic is currently an associate professor and graduate advisor of humanities and cultural studies at the University of Florida, teaching musicology courses.
So the lecture is based on like a recent research project of mine, and I've gotten more interested lately in film music. But before that, I was interested in music and trauma. And so I've kind of gotten into this, thinking about this question about the way in which film music works in terms of representing traumatic scenarios on film and how the music might mediate or shape the relationship of the viewer to the events on screen.
Youngstown is lucky to have White House Fruit Farms and their fresh fruit and family-friendly activities. Our reporters Jordan and Ethan have more.
White House Fruit Farms has been a family-owned business since the 1800s, where it was originally a turkey farm, but has since turned into one of the biggest fruit farms right here in Ohio. We were able to talk to Debbie Piper.
You know, you always need to support the businesses in your community. Whether it's a produce business, or it's a car business, or it's a jewelry business, you always want to support the folks that live in your community. And so number one, it helps the entire local economy, first of all, be a better productive economy. Secondly, it keeps our dollars local. But thirdly, food that's produced right here in Ohio, we have fabulous soils to produce produce. It tastes better, it's fresher, and so that's what we try to promote.
This is one of the most popular seasons for White House. Every weekend till the end of October, they host their annual fall festivities. Be sure to come out for all the fun. Reporting for Light the Wick, I'm Jordan Galkus.
This past week, YSHE was able to help celebrate the Jewish festival of Sukkot. During the special week, a temporary hut is constructed called a sukkah. This hut was found on the outside patio of DeBartlow Hall. It is topped with branches and sometimes decorated with autumn or Judaic themes.
The holiday of Sukkot takes place after the Jewish New Year and after the Day of Atonement and marks the end of a period in which Jews celebrate the new year and atone for the sins of the previous year so that they may start the new one in good relations with God and each other.
Traditional Jews in Israel will often eat, study, and sleep in the sukkah throughout the week. In colder climates, they do not. The festival is considered a happy time for everyone. Buying local is an important part in helping our community thrive. The Youngstown Flea Market is a great way to help small, local businesses grow. Our reporters Ethan and Jordan have more.
Today we were able to visit the last Youngstown Flea Market of the season, and we were able to talk to local vendors about what it means to sell local.
So my business is Matique Boutique, and what I do is I take antiques. I do a lot of upcycling, recycling, and repurposing of old antique items. So yeah, we're featured in the Park Avenue Marketplace in Columbiana. It's a great store, has other artisans. We're featured there, and we have a nice booth that's about 10 by 10 square feet. So I'm a firm believer of recycling. It's good that we can take old antique items that we still have a lot of homes that are out there that can be reused and stuff like that. So it's very important to recycle and, you know, keep Mother Earth green.
Started, it's Kathleen's Classics. We work out of my home. Well, as long when you buy local, then you keep everything local because I spend local. So I take your money and then I keep it in the community. So we continue to support our community and help our community to grow.
So I upcycle and I have a wood shop. So I custom make like signs and do a lot of custom orders for people.
Well, I love the like vintage feel of something that somebody, you know, just looked at and they just didn't like it anymore, but then I can repaint it or, you know, do something or add something to it and just give it new life. And I love that. I love breathing new life into things.
Be sure to visit the Youngstown Flea Market next upcoming year. Reporting for Light the Wick, I'm Jordan Galkus.
That's all for this week's episode. If you have any stories you would like us to cover, send us a message to the social media pages listed on the screen. Thank you from all of us here at Light the Wick. I'm your host, Ashley Munson. Have a great week, Youngstown.